Now we have studied that objects can be sorted based on different types. Now you can see that we have materials which have different properties. So we can say that materials can be classified based on their different properties, or you can simply say that property of a material can be different. So we are going to study the five properties of any materials that are possible. You can have the appearance, hardness, solubility, buoyancy, and the last one is the transparency. So let us discuss each of them in detail. First of all, appearance. Now a material may appear shiny and lustrous. Lustrous means shiny only. So an appearance of the object decides how is it going to be. You can have the look at the gold ornaments that our mothers wear, and you can see it in your homes, that is having very shiny appearance, right? Also, you must have seen the new aluminium articles or new iron articles that you get from the market are having a very shiny surface on them. But after a time, their shine gets reduced due to the atmospheric moisture and oxygen. Also, you can have the next property of the materials, that is hardness. Some materials may appear to be very soft to you. That is, you can scratch them, you can compress them, right? Such materials that can be compressed or scratched easily are known as the soft materials, and the ones that cannot be will be known as the hard materials. The next property we have is solubility. You can take two beakers, each having the full water level. Now you take sand and put it into one beaker, and you take salt and put it into another beaker. Now with the help of a spoon, you stir both the beakers to make the contents dissolve. After some point of time, you would be able to notice that the contents of the salt in water has been completely dissolved, whereas the sand still remains insoluble. So that is where the solubility comes up. The salt has become completely dissolved into the solvent, that is water. So salt is soluble in water, whereas the sand remains as it is. It is not getting dissolved in water. So we say that sand is insoluble in water. So we have the solubility, that means the materials can be soluble as well as insoluble. Here I have taken up example of water. You can have any other liquid in which the solubility check can be done. The next property is buoyancy. Buoyancy means you must have observed when you are passing by some village or some forest, you must have seen their ponds, and ponds have the dried leaves over them floating. Now, how is it decided that which object is going to float on water and which object is going to sink? If you throw a stone into the pond, you would find that your stone sinks into the bottom, right? And that decides the buoyancy. Buoyancy means there are some objects that are going to float and there are some objects which always sink based on their densities. So you can have the object's property as buoyancy. The last one is transparency. Now you have the three types of transparency classifications. One is the transparent objects, other one is the opaque objects, and the third one is the translucent objects. Transparent objects are the objects through which we can completely see through. That is, you can see through your glass windows, right? So glass is one example of transparent objects. Opaque objects are such objects through which we cannot see through at all. You can see this board over here. This is opaque because I cannot see through this, right? So the substances through which we cannot see through are the opaque substances. Also, the third one is the translucent. Translucent objects are those objects through which partially you can see the object. Partially means to some extent you are able to see, but not completely. Now, can you think of any good example of translucent object? Translucent object can be taken up as the butter paper that you have. Or you can use a paper and put some oil on the paper. You would be able to see through the paper to some extent. You will have some blurred image of the object behind the paper, but you will not be able to see it completely as you will be able to see in transparent case, right? So translucent objects are such objects through which we can see through partially but not completely. So these were the five properties of the materials we have studied.